Nagraj. He is currently working as assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry, Anna University, Chennai. Earlier, he worked as a scientist in charge at Spices Board of India for 5 years in research and development and also in quality control laboratory. He has finished his PhD in organic chemistry at IIT Delhi. He has also done his MSc Chemical Science at Pondicherry Central University. He has published 6 papers in international journal and also participated several international events in India and abroad. He has attended several conferences and delivered lecture as keynote speaker and also undergone 12 training programs. His area of research interests are isolation, synthesis of natural products and evaluation of their biological activities, carbohydrate-based natural product synthesis, enzyme catalyst organic synthesis, green chemistry, medicinal aspects of spices and spice products.
Welcome to UGC lecture series in polymer science. Today we are going to see special property of some of the polymers, especially polyoxymethylene and polyphenylene sulfide and polyphenylene oxide, polyamide imide, polyether imide. These are all the polymers we are going to study extensively in this class. So, today's content is overview of specific polymers, polyoxymethylene polymers, properties and its uses, polyamide imide synthesis and its application, polyphenylene oxide, polyphenylene sulfide, polyether imide synthesis and its application. Overview we have seen already in the previous lectures. So, we should choose the material which should relatively cheap and which is having very good properties and it should be easily available. These things are very, very important. Based on that, the overview of when choosing a material for a specific applications, generally the least expensive material that will do the job is chosen. So, this is very, very important point. And when you are searching for the right resin for the job, many factors will come into play and they all will be balanced against the cost. Factors such as dimensional stability, service temperature range and impact strength, these three are very, very important. The material should be obey all these kind of properties, then only which should be easily to choose for our purpose. And can all cost material to be eliminated from the list is possible choice. Engineering plastics are typically chosen for their superior properties, that is very, very important. But if the commodity plastic can do the job, it is the obvious choice. So, plastic material going to do the job compared to metallic material, that means plastic material will be the choice for choosing these properties or this kind of applications. One of the polymer is polyoxymethylene, generally known as acetal or POM. So, this is the structure where carbon having 2 hydrogen which is linked to oxygen. This is the monomeric unit which will make polymer chain to produce a polymer. History, developed by DuPont in 1950s, polyoxymethylene is used in many applications where there are moving components due to its low coefficient of friction and high stiffness. So, the molecule which is having high stiffness and low coefficient of friction, that is very, very important property of this material. So, which is widely used in this kind of area. So, POM or polyoxymethylene is a commonly available in either the homopolymer of copolymer forms. I already discussed what is a homopolymer, the single monomeric unit which will repeat to produce polymer which is a homopolymer. That means, one type of monomer which is present to produce the polymer. Copolymer, 2 different types of monomer which can undergo polymerization will produce a polymer which is called copolymer. So, in both way polyoxymethylene we can prepare either homopolymer or by copolymer. The homopolymer is stiffer and melts at high temperature while the copolymer is more ductile and attain lower level of crystallinity. So, this is the beauty. Homopolymer means which can brittle and melts very easily compared to copolymer which can withstand this ductility which is lower level of crystallinity. This is the difference between these two. So, again polyoxymethylene density the specific gravity of acetal is about 1.41, which makes it one of the more dense thermoplastic material. Plastics are bought by weight and sold by volume. Having a high density is a definite disadvantage. And other property like crystallinity, highly crystalline, can attain a crystallinity around 95%. So this is a very good polymer. This is purely crystalline polymer. That means the arrangements of atoms in the molecule, which is proper arrangement compared to other polymers. Some of the polymers which is amorphous, the arrangements of atoms or molecule which is random in nature. In the case of polyoxymethylene, which is orderly arranged, that's why it's getting crystalline structure. And other properties, hygroscopy, water absorbing tendency, should be dried at 200 degree Fahrenheit for 1 to 2 hours or until it reaches a moisture content 0.05%. So moisture, the molecule can easily absorb water, that is the property which is hygroscopic. So the molecule should be, or the polymer should be dried up to 0.05% of water, until that we have to heat it or make it dry. Cross transition temperature is minus 100 Fahrenheit, melting temperature is minus 350 degree Fahrenheit. The price is around 1.2 per pound. Mechanical properties, very good to excellent mechanical properties. It also has a very low coefficient of friction and is very wear resistant, which makes it an excellent choice for bushings, bearings and gears. So this kind of material which is used in this field, bushings, bearings and gears, because of which is having very wear resistant and it makes low coefficient of friction. These two properties very important to make this molecule having very good mechanical properties. And a chemical resistant, much like a nylon and polyoxymethylene, has excellent chemical resistance to most chemical media, but it is weak when exposed to strong acids and chlorine. Avoid mixing with PVC. PVC nothing but polyvinyl chloride. So if you are mixing with polyvinyl chloride, what will happen? The chlorine molecule will attack the polyoxymethylene. So we should not keep it near, or we should not mix with PVC. On the other hand, which is react with the strong acid or base, the molecule can undergo hydrolysis, or because oxymethylene means it's a ether linkage again, that can undergo hydrolysis if you are using very strong acid or base. So we should not keep it very strong acid or base or chlorine in place of polyoxymethylene. Again, the acetal, which is having optical properties, poor optical properties due to its high crystalline content. So the crystallinity is very high, it's up to 95%, which is crystalline nature. So which is very poor in optical property because of the structural arrangement. It almost always appears white unless colored due to the high number of crystals. So which is a transparent crystalline polymer, which doesn't have any color, which is colorless. And the flammability, another class of properties, where polyoxymethylene will burn and continue to burn. When burned, it gives a smell of formaldehyde. It is very difficult to see the flame when it burns. So which is smokeless burning. While burning, it will produce formaldehyde, because the molecule which is made from formaldehyde, polyoxymethylene, HCHO, this is the unit. I will normally unit or molecular formula for formaldehyde. So while burning, it will release formaldehyde. We will get the smell of formaldehyde, and with less smokes. And another properties, electrical properties, which we can see here, very good electrical properties, commonly used for twist on electrical connectors. And polyoxymethylene, again weatherability, processability, thermal sensitivity. In case of weatherability, polyoxymethylene exhibits poor weathering resistant, that means it is easily undergo weathering. Its high level of crystallinity causes it to absorb a large amount of UV light, which accelerate oxidation. So weatherability, which is very poor, that means which can easily undergo weathering, it can crack or it can get broken. And the second thing is, which is a crystalline nature, so which can absorb UV radiation, that means which can absorb UV radiation, which is harmful, which can go and attack the molecule, the molecule will get undergo oxidation. Once the molecule gets oxidation, then the properties gets changed, or molecule will get decomposed or changed to other molecule. So weatherability properties are very poor. Again, the processability easily processed, but it has high shrinkage rates, which can make holding tight tolerance difficult. So shrinkage rate is very high, the molecules. So processability is easy, but the shrinkage is very high. So it's almost it's a flexible property. And the thermal sensitivity, again it is necessary to avoid excessive resistant times when processing polyoxymethylene. It will degrade relatively quickly, and when it does, it gives off formaldehyde gas. We already discussed the polymer which is made by monomer formaldehyde, so which can easily thermal resistivity relatively less, which can easily produce formaldehyde gas while prolonged heatings. Decoration and assembly, it is very difficult to assemble and decorate polyoxymethylene. It's a low coefficient of friction, make it difficult to adhere inks, paints, and adhesive to the surface. So the friction is less, so it can't acquire or adhere the material like ink, paint, and adhesive material to its surface. Many thermoplastic assembly methods use friction to cause enough heat to melt the material in order to bond the surface together. The low surface friction makes it difficult to generate the necessary heat for bonding. So surface friction is less, that means there is no much friction, it won't adhere anything. Like if you want to make some color or something over it, it won't accept because of the friction is very less. And the grip, its extremely high level of crystallinity increases the creep resistant of the material. So this property is very high. And recyclability, not commonly recycled alone, generally lumped in with 7 category. So whatever polymer which is come under this 7 category, which won't be recycled frequently or alone, which may be linked with something else, and it can be a very less number of times recycled compared to other polymers. Again, application of polyoxymethylene in case of consumer goods, gears, rollers, buildings, guitar picks, backpack, buckles, and even yo-yo are common application of polyoxymethylene. The picture shown here, some belt which is made by polyoxymethylene. And in place of medical application and automotive industry, polyoxymethylene shows up in the medical field many times when the application require to surface to slide under pressure. It is not as a common in the medical field as some other material, because special grades must be used when the parts require sterilization by some method. So medical field, this polyoxymethylene not used widely, because the apparatus which is used in the medical field, which you have to undergo autoclave or sterilization process. So this kind of condition, this material may not be stable enough to use in the medical field. Whereas in case of automotive field, it is a high density when compared to the other plastics, limits polyoxymethylene's applications in the automotive area. It is commonly used in the small gears and electrical switches though. So this density is high. Once the molecule having very high density, what will happen? High density molecule weight will increase. So industry prefer to choose lightweight material. So if that is the case, this material will be not chosen as the preferred material over the other one because of very high density in nature. Again, another class of application of polyoxymethylene in the field of packaging. POM is not commonly seen in packaging field. It doesn't possess properties that would justify the higher price associated with its high density. So because of density very high, the rate of price also very high. So in case of packaging field, which is not suitable, and moreover the peculiar property the molecule should have, barrier, act as a barrier between the gas molecule in the packed material, then only which is suitable for used in the packaging field, whereas this is not that much used in the field of packaging. Our other field is a construction, electrical connectors and switches, rollers, gears, bushings and some plumbing fittings are common applications of polyoxymethylene in the construction field. So it is not mainly used as main construction material, whereas which is used as a some part of the material which can be used in the domestic household. So as a summary, we can compare all the material where nylon, polymethyl methacrylate and polyoxymethylene, in case of tensile strength, tensile modules, chemical resistant, optical and flammability, which is very good in case of nylon for chemical resistant. In case of polyoxymethylene also is very good, whereas PMMA is moderate, whereas optical property PMMA having excellent compared to these two. Flammability is very good in case of nylon compared to these two, so some of them shown here. And nylon PMMA POM having electrical weathering processing creep recycling. So in case of nylon as having very good electrical property, polyoxymethylene also compared to PMMA, weathering which is a PMMA having excellent compared to these two, and processing processability polyoxymethylene having good compared to these two. Creep resistant, almost all the three are equal, this slightly poor in case of polyoxymethylene. And recyclability, all the three are moderate. And this is the six polymer which we discussed so far for engineering polymers. The combinedly we can see the properties like density, crystalline property, hygroscopic, glass transition temperature and melting temperature, which is shown in the table, especially which is polyethylene terephthalate, which is a crystalline, and nylon also, and polyoxymethylene, whereas all of the molecule having hygroscopic property where it can absorb moisture in atmospheric air. And the temperature which is very high, 300 degrees Celsius in case of polycarbonate glass transition temperature, compared to all other polymer. Polyoxymethylene which is a minus 100 degree, and the melting temperature again the highest one is these two, PET and nylon, which is having 510 Fahrenheit compared to other polymers. Another class of polymer is polyphenylene sulfide. This is can be synthesized with dichlorobenzene, react with sodium sulfide in presence of NMP 270 degree Celsius will produce a phenyl ring which is attached with the sulfur. This is the monomeric unit which can produce a polymer with similar units in place of repeating. So which is polyphenylene sulfide is again is a linear polymer. The glass transition temperature is 85 degree Celsius, melting is 285 degree, and molecular weight of approximately 20,000 gram per mole. So this is again polyphenylene oxide which is shown in the picture, where the benzene molecule which is linked with oxygen, this is a monomeric unit. This monomeric unit have two substituent on the both side of the substituent of oxygen, which will repeat, will produce a polymer. So which is comes under category of thermoplastic. The glass transition temperature is 208 degree Celsius and acid base resistant, so which is highly resistant towards chemicals, and poor solvent resistant means which can easily soluble in aromatic solvents, example shown here, toluene, this molecule can easily soluble, and high strength because of presence of this oxygen in the aromatic ring, which is having more strength, a good stiffness and low CTE, not melt processable, sold as blend with PS and PPS polyphenylene sulfide, this which is 85 degree Celsius, 285, here it is 208, relatively very high than PPS. Polyphenylene oxide, how it can be synthesized here, which is shown. So dimethyl phenol taken and react with oxygen in presence of copper catalyst, toluene as a solvent, to produce this material as a polymer. This is the monomeric unit where the phenolic oxygen having two substituent on the adjacent position will repeat the unit, will produce a polymer. So need to block ortho position in this case of this polymerization, branching and X linking, usually methyl. So in this polymer, these two sides should be protected. Otherwise, what will happen in this reaction? The instead of getting polymerization, which can undergo side reaction, like making some other molecule instead of making this polymer. So this ortho position of this phenolic two position should be blocked with inert group, especially methyl group, and branching with X linking, maybe halogen or something should be there in order to increase the property of the molecules. Another class is shown here, polyimides, where nitrogen having all the three valency filled as a tertiary in nature, both aromatic ring present here, this side and this side, which will give more strength to the polymer. So, property of this polyimides, which is again high strength because of this kind of linkage, and tough in nature, and oxidative stability, because which is a more stable molecule, there is no place the molecule will get oxidation, and hydrolytically stable because this is kind of amide linkage, very high stability towards hydrolysis, and high class transition temperature and high thermal stability. So this is the beauty of polyimides compared to polyamides, which is having advantages like this. So imide, in this case the nitrogen, which is a tertiary in nature, so there is no other link may be there in the nitrogen, which is very difficult to undergo hydrolysis or react with the chemicals. So the thermal stability as well as chemical resistant gets increased compared to polyamides in case of polyimides. Another class of polymer which is shown here, Kapton TM polyether imide. A structure shown here is a diamine, which is having ether linked diamine, one amino group here, one more amino group here, para substituted diamine, ether linked phenyl ring, react with dianhydride, the benzene, which is both side having dianhydride at room temperature. What will happen? A ring opening polymerization happened here. The amino group react with this carbonyl group to open the ring, and similarly one more amino group react with this anhydride to produce disubstituted, both side the benzene ring substituted with this molecule here and this here, to produce this kind of intermediate, which is polyamic acid. So amide is there, acid is there in the adjacent carbon, both side will produce polyamic acid. To heat, cyclodehydration takes place, that means the hydrogen from amine and the hydroxy group will undergo dehydration, will give corresponding this kind of anhydride with where the nitrogen substituted this position. So simply what we are doing here, the oxygen replaced with nitrogen in the both side of this dianhydride will produce this kind of polymer, which is having totally different kind of property than the existing polymers. So polyamic acid heat to produce this intractable, insoluble, and the glass transition temperature greater than 325 degrees Celsius. This is the peculiar property. The molecule cannot be insoluble because of this high kind of linkage with amide and oxygen, and intractable, which is sterically hindered molecule. Moreover, rigidity will be very high compared to normal polymer because of these kind of structural arrangements. So again, processable polyimides, this X may be here, maybe oxygen or carbonyl group or sulfate, whereas Y may be here, again sulfate, oxygen or carbonyl group. In the different, two different anhydride which is linked by heteroatom, in the earlier case we have seen only one benzene ring having dianhydride, whereas here you can introduce a heteroatom which is linked between two phenyl ring which is having this anhydride, react with diamine which is again having the heteroatom at room temperature to produce polyamic acid, which is shown in the previous slide, undergo cyclodehydration to produce this kind of complex molecule where the X may be SO2, O or CO. this sulfone containing polymer having special properties. So if you need this kind of sulfone, you can introduce sulfone here, and here you can get more stable polymer than the other one. If you want, you can introduce carbonyl group, you can introduce here as a starting material, you can take it as a carbonyl group in the both the substituent, you will get carbonyl group substituted product. If you need oxygen, which already we have seen in the previous slide, you can introduce oxygen substituted the starting material, you will get back the corresponding product. So this polyamic acid undergo cyclodehydration under heat condition to produce this kind of imide, which can be hydrolytically thermally stable imide will be produced. This is again also class of thermoplastics polyimides, melt processable in 260 to 325 degree Celsius range. So application of this kind of polymer is tough unfilled moldings, strong adhesives, composites. This is the beauty. Again Altum TM polyether imide, so which is another class of polymer where the imide, this is the imide portion which is linked by a benzene ring, react with dihydroxyphenol compound to produce ether link between this imide and ether. So polyether imide, which can produce this kind of polymer, the class transition temperature is 217 degree Celsius. Similarly, this kind of molecule we can make it in the form of imide if provided amino group present here, will make polyether imide polymer. So Siltum polymers, again we can introduce n number of heteroatom. In the case of substituent, you can produce siloxane containing polyimides if you are using silicon as the backbone of the polymeric material. The imparts is a lower surface energy, hydrophobicity, oxygen plasma resistant, increased toughness. This is the peculiar properties. Polyamide imide, extremely resistant to flame, quite low smoke generations. However, PAAs is attacked by some acids at high temperature and by steam at high pressure and temperature. Usually in structural parts which require high strength at high temperature, aerospace product, underground environment, automotive parts, timing gear, piston rigs, etc. So summary, we have seen overall what is a polyoxymethylene and followed by polyphenylene sulfide and polyphenylene oxide and its applications and synthesis, polyamide imide synthesis and applications we have studied in elaborately. These are all the questions. What is a polyoxymethylene polymer, polyphenylene oxide and its applications, polyether imide and its uses, polyamide imide properties and its industrial applications. Within this session, we conclude these sessions. Thank you.